Welcome back to our DM7 training videos. We've already taken a tour of the hardware. Now I'm going to guide you through the on-screen GUI. The screens are 12.1 inches, big, bright, and beautiful. You may recognize similarities with Yamaha's RIVAGE PM systems and also with CL and QL series digital mixers. Yet, there are also some unique features, especially when it comes to the 7-inch utility screen. Anyway, let's begin by pressing the familiar home key. Then you can choose to see all the details for the selected channel or an overview of the 12 channels linked to the faders below. Select the range of channels from the fader bank keys and the adjacent virtual keys on the screen. Channel names are always displayed along the bottom edge of the screen with level meters and icons. The meter bridge is at the top, which also works as channel navigation. Touch a meter block to change the fader layers. Touch the arrow on the right to switch between output or custom meters, or view the meter's full screen. The rest of the screen's top edge is dedicated to menu access. Top left is the scene menu, which shows the title and number of the current scene and info about the next scene to be recalled. Touch to open the scene screen. Here you see the list of up to 500 scenes with title, comment, and time stamp. See additional information by touching focus or fade time and so on. Use the recall safe and global paste screens for more advanced scene memory management. These features work in a similar way to RIVAGE PM series, so you can find training videos about them. The patch menu is where we see the input and output connections for the mixer. Note there is a list view, a grid view, and a helpful universe view. And note there's a dedicated recording patch for easy virtual sound checks. When you make a patch, you can define a new sequential patch range to set a long line of channels in one quick operation. The rack menu is where we find the three virtual racks: premium, effects, and EQ racks. The premium rack is mainly used for insert processing and includes a range of vintage and modern analog virtual circuitry modeling, such as the legendary Rupert Neve Designs items. And there's the amazing Dance Dynamic Noise Suppressor. The effects rack is mainly for send and return types of effects such as reverbs and delays. Make sure you try out the newly added HD and R3 reverbs with their impressively smooth realism. Then the EQ rack contains 32 units for 64 channels of graphic and parametric EQ. We'll need to cover more detail in a future video. At the top right is the main menu, with access to setup and preferences, customization options, bus setup, control options, and so on. Further down, we see I/O device, which includes the Dante setup, device mount, and patching. Next, we have USB recorder functions, then the Live Rec menu, which will control Nuendo Live multi-track recording software, either via Dante or USB connection. The monitor menu includes cue, oscillator, and talkback, while the channel job menu hosts DCA and mute group assign, channel link, channel copy, and set to default. Similar to Yamaha's other recent digital mixers. Let's press the home key again and take a look at a few more details. In this 12-channel overview, you can see most of the channel strip, input meters at the top, and indicators for direct out, delay, and Dugan auto mixing. No need to insert Dugan separately, it's already in place. Just activate it for as many as 64 channels. Touch to see the detail. Gain, polarity, and phantom power are next. Touch to adjust with the encoders, and touch again to view more detail. Dynamics, EQ, and inserts are below, and again, you can touch to see the details. After you've looked at one detailed view, you can move to another with the tabs near the top of the screen. Gain, dynamics, EQ, insert, delay, and so on. Press X or home to return to the overview. You can swap the position of EQ and dynamics too, with a drag and a drop. Towards the bottom, you can see pan, main stereo routing, and mute group and DCA assignments. If you want to see mix and matrix sends, just press the send key further up the channel strip. Then you will see a bar graph of 56 sends with level, pre, and on for the selected one. Touch to see more details and drag horizontally to adjust the level. Drag vertically to scroll through the sends, and note the handy shortcuts for setting the level to 0, minus 6, or minus infinity. Back to the selected channel view, and you can see a huge amount of detail for one channel. Touch and drag the parameters in the EQ and dynamics windows, and assign the parameters to the encoders below. Use these shortcuts to expand or collapse the views. You can directly access the inserted plugins here too for parameter editing. The signal flow is shown along the top of the selected channel window, starting with the patch and moving through to the channel on key, with the mix and matrix sends charted below that. Notice the EQ thumbnail can again be dragged to swap positions with dynamics too. Sends on fader can be activated by the key to the right of the screen. Then use the screen to select the mix bus. Next, you can choose to collapse the sends view while remaining in sends on fader mode. Touch this little widget to open the selection again, or drag to move it out of the way. Alternatively, employ some user-defined keys to access specific sends on fader. I like to use the utility screen for this. User-defined banks 2 and 3 are preset for this purpose. It's a really fast way to work, and the selected mix channel fader can appear in the main section below. So now let's consider other uses for the utility screen. When you press home at the top right, it shows the time, main output, level meters, and a menu. There are also indicators for the function of the encoders below the screen. They are user-defined and can control the brightness of the panel and the lights. There are four banks of options, and one is perfect for operators familiar with RIVAGE PM or CL and QL consoles, as it assigns selected channel functions to the encoders, including A gain, D gain, HPF, and pan. We've seen the user-defined keys, which can be page bookmarks or send on fader and many other shortcuts and options. Monitor provides quick access to output and source select. Scene list is another useful one, allowing scene memories to be displayed with update, store, and recall keys. Save and load is for file management on a USB key. Assist we'll look at another time. It's a useful level setting tool for less experienced operators. In System menu, you can choose Split Mode, which will divide the console into two virtual mixers for two separate tasks. It's very clever and practical, and I'll demonstrate it in a later video. Next time, let's work through all the different options and accessories we have for DM7 series, including the theatre and broadcast packages. See you soon.